Hello, Easy Company. The guy always keeping it strictly unprofessional here to do game three. Dougster. Woog Moog, Uncle Woog. Here to do it. On the west-hand side of Samoys, we've got Dtox there, the man from the land down under. Going to be playing as the Brits. He must be missing the old colonial days, so he's going to go back and play his roots. Very strange. I didn't know you could play Brits in this tournament. We haven't seen those guys yet. They're cheeky little fellows and like to sip their tea. On the right-hand side, though, if we go to the far east, the man from the down south Alabama country. That sounds more like Forrest Gump, doesn't it? Recon there on the right-hand side. He's going to be playing as Vermont. We're on Samoys. I'm at the 5-second market. Oh! Oh my goodness, look at this. Here comes the trophy. The trophy's now walking in. Here it is. Yep, bring it in here, fellas. Okay. Okay, yeah, set it down. The trophy, oh wow, you should see this thing. Don't drop it. Wow, this thing is a big trophy these two guys are playing for. Put it down there on the mantle. There you go, fellas. It looks to be like it's a sock. A crusty old sock, and it has EC and a Sharpie letters written on the top of it as like a trophy, and it's got a little plaque and thing there. It's very cool, little sock-looking thing. And then plus, we're going to be able to give the guys a complimentary embalmed toenail clippers, which are very cool. Yeah, those are cool. I got those in my hands right now. And those are neat little things. So put those down there, too. So the trophy is here in the medic bunker, in the station, where we're going to be watching this game. Very cool. We've got the trophy. We've got the game. Game three, finally. We're going to find out who wins this thing. We're going to find out who gets the grand prize to visit the Queen in London during the Olympics. Let's start it. I'm at the 5-second mark. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, unpause. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So we've been waiting a little while to get this cast out. I went on vacay, you know, and my liver doing these casts is pretty much ready to jump out my butt and then strangle me using my intestines due to how much beers I've been drinking during these time sinks. And it's all good, though. I'll survive this one. But Recon, he's going to go Wehrmacht. Recon was strong there earlier on, and he did some good things, coming back, winning in Game 2. Game 1 was owned by Tox, and Tox is going to be capping right outside of Dog 1, that northern bridge on the western side. He's going to be coming out, going to be doing, hopefully set up a little cafe there in the middle. I know how those Brits love their tea. But after this cast, I think I might slip back into obscurity and never be seen again, at least in the shoutcasting world. I've got the air conditioner rolling right now. I think it's about 90 degrees. I would say I won't even put that in Celsius, but it's hot. It's hot like this game should be. Folks coming out. Dog 2 from Recon there, just Southern Bridge. They're going to be moving into town. Going to be disrupting the cafe emplacement. Second Infantry Squad. Recon showing his disgruntledness right there by saying that Tox went with the Brits, but you can see the Brits in that base, that British base there, how slow they move. They are quite cheeky fellows. Boy, I could really do a lot of British jokes here tonight, but I will hold off. Folks meet the infantry section there in the middle, just east of the center VP. Gonna share a few bullets. Share some hospitality with each other. Schwitzwagen Type 166 completed from Recon. He's going to be bringing that out. Folks moving around the building, they don't really want to engage those infantrymen, but they get in the green cover. The Brits are very tough in that green cover. They can't be suppressed in the green cover, and the Schwitzwagen is going to push them around. Volks jump into the building, going to give some bullet fire onto those British fellows. And the British guys don't know really what to do. They're kind of confused right now. Tox kind of moving them around, trying to figure it out how he gets them in the green cover. Schwitzwagen pushing them around, giving a few fires off. They do move to the side of the building so the Volks can't shoot at them. Smart move by Tox. Meanwhile, we have some capping going on. Recon floating a ton of manpower. He must be preoccupied in the middle there, controlling the Schwitzwagen. Folks still sitting in the building, taking damage from the right side. from the northern side. Schutzwagen moving in to try to push him off again. Trying to push him back into the road so the folks can get a look at him. Folks jump out of the building. Schutzwagen badly damaged. Going to have to back off. Here come the Volks squad, going to run up and try and get a close combat, using the bayonets out there. Brits down to four men, Volks down to four men. Volks got the green cover advantage. Oh, my goodness. Infantry section down to two men. They got to run. But if we look, we go to the tactical map very quickly. We have an infantry section hanging out by the British truck. We have another infantry section hanging out on the right VP. Time sync coming on. 3 minutes. 50 seconds, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55. Sniper coming out from Recon. We don't have an MG from Recon yet. I guess he doesn't like to use those against the Brits. Smart move, I guess. If you were Brits, you just could put up a mortar emplacement. You do seem kind of naked, like a chick without a skirt on prom night, if you don't have your MG out there as a Wehrmacht player, but you are playing the Brits, and the Brits don't prefer chicks in skirts. Brits jump in the church, genuflect. There they go. Going to be firing out from the gods and Jesus' house. Sniper on the right-hand side, very nice move for Recon. Going to be pounding those Brits a little bit. Brits don't have that rifle on the right-hand side. They don't have that sniper rifle that they have. And that sniper's going to be uncontested there on the right-hand side. Brits moving into the middle, though. Let's go to the middle VP. Going to battle some Volks. Volks grab some cover at the cafe. That firefight's going on. The sniper joins in. Going to do some poaching just south of the center VP. Here comes the Geschützwagen, almost the full toolbox. You can actually hear it. There it goes. Another Brit squad walks in. That's the infantry section there. That they have that special scoped gun, but the sniper's still picking them off. Two snipers now. I missed that. That guy came out of nowhere. Volks Geschützwagen, two snipers. Meanwhile, they're facing off against three infantry section with a lieutenant there in the base. Sniper's going to retreat there back to base. The Brits are going to stick around, going to hang in that road there. The red cover is really, really steep for the manpower, or for the life drain, if you will. Geschützwagen really giving a hard time. Tox really underhanded there. He's got to run. Brits, meanwhile, capping the center VP. Recon has capped that fuel right outside his base, the plus 18. And he's got most of the map here. Pretty much going to be, he's probably going to start suffocating Tox here. Tox, oh, very strange to see him go Brit. God, bothers me a little bit. I would have liked to seen a pure vanilla American Wehrmacht, but I'm not playing this. And that trophy over there is for one of these guys. And we do have some Brit players. I noticed that your Brits are really hard to master. They're very hard. And once you master them, boy, are they tough to beat. But back to the game. Time sync coming on during this. Lull in the action. 6 minutes, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50. Thank you for sticking around with me as I slowly take backward steps towards obscurity again. Nitro sending a whisper there. I know it's not to me. Tox going to make a move to the northern side, trying to rock the boat. I got some laughs about that. That was pretty cool. Guys liking the sayings. I know I got more sayings than a chimpanzee, but, you know, bear with me. The enemy is taking our territory. Sniper's moving up north, though. We're kind of going to be doing his thing. Brit's moving into the middle, though, so the sniper should be making a move down towards the center. The Brits, left-hand side of the church there at the center VP. Here come the Brits, though. They could. Wow, if he knew where the snipers were, Tox could move up that rifled infantry section and pick off those snipers. And he is. He's moving them up. He could catch those snipers off guard. Oh, my God. He could lose one here. There could be a shot here. They set up. Ooh, a missed sniper shot.
Wow.
That was close. That would have been huge. Lucky. Yep. Recon did luck out there. BS, you know, sniper shots, no matter who's shooting it, if you're doing a sniper shot, there's nitro there. If you're doing a sniper shot on a retreating unit, it's very hard to get that lucky shot. So I guess you could say it's luck, but you should know that's going to happen. I think both these guys know that, but they're a little perturbed about that. Brit's going to make it known that they're in the middle, and down south we do have a Stuart light tank. Going to be moving up from the south. Going to be in some trouble since Recon has no AT. He doesn't even have Tier 2 up right now. He's going to have to... I bet you he goes Blitz. I bet you he goes Blitz here, and he's going to try to Shrek up with the Stormtroopers. Nitro still plaguing me with his text messages. Sniper's got to run, though. The tank's there. Here comes the Stuart, going to give those Volks a lot of trouble. Stuart's a little bit stronger than that M8 that you usually get as Americans. I'd rather have an M8, if you ask me. That 50 cal sounds so sweet. Sniper's back to base, though. The Stuart's going to chase him back into the Wehrmacht base. Here go the Sniper's going to jump into the HQ. Take some cover there. One's on the shitter, the other's on the pisser, and they're trying to shoot out that window. Snipers jump out. Now they're going to try and probably cloak and make a sneaky getaway. Here come the Blitz Stormtroopers. Called it perfectly again, folks. This is why I keep it strictly unprofessional.
We are losing ground.
I know I'm good. Shrek's going to be taking some damage with the Stuart. There's another Shrek shot. Stuart really, really down to low health. He might be able to keep it if he gets out now, but he's going to hang around. Stormtroopers heavily damaged. They're down to, like, nothing on health. Here comes another Stuart tank to join the party. MG going to give fire to it from the bunker. That's not going to do much. Stormtroopers pretty much got... I think they have just one Shrek for now. That should be enough to at least keep those frickin' predators at bay. Meanwhile, Tox is capping up the whole map while Recon's sitting back in his base. Long replay, though. We're at about 10 minutes and 40 seconds coming on here. And it's a long replay, so we might see a decent comeback here. Tox really trying to jump on Recon in a non-homosexual way very early in the game. Another Shrek shot on that Stuart. There goes the Stuart, plus 18 XP. Floating up into the sky, the Blitz guys decide to retreat back to base. Folks with their PP guns, the MP40s there, going to be trying to shoot at the Stuart. Shrek gets involved again with the Blitz troopers, the Stormtroopers. Blitz troopers, what am I talking about? Stuart tank going to stick around though, harass a bit. Tox is really throwing his tanks away just to get the advantage of taking the map. Sniper's moving out away from the Wehrmacht base down the road. Oh my goodness, if you look towards the base though, tons of XP flying up. Buckshot used on the Volks as well as the Stormtroopers. Main gun destroys as the Stuart walks away, licking its wounds. Sniper's still out by the middle, just southeast of the center VP. Going to be hanging out there, hiding in the bushes. Recon got a lot of ground to make up here, but he's at T4 coming out with an Ast win. 353 to 435 in favor of Tox. Coming out strong there with the early Brit attack with the Stuart. Sniper's poaching in the middle. Recon going to be coming back here. He's going to have the Blitz, the Stormtroopers, as well as an Ostwin. And I don't know if Tox has anything to answer that. Time sync coming out at 12 minutes and 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. So, very cool. I got a few compliments from the guys, and I take it as a compliment. The guys said that they could listen to the cast without watching the replay, and I thought that was very cool. I guess they're that entertaining that you can actually watch them on the radio, or not watch them, but listen to them while you're at work. And you don't really have to watch the replay, and that's pretty cool. That's very neat to, that's almost a compliment, you know, when you're describing a game close enough to where someone can actually visualize it in their mind without actually seeing it. Very cool. But let's get back to the game. Enough of that pats on the back and such. Ashwin moving into the middle. Blitz Stormtrooper guy is going to be moving into the church. Genuflect. Sniper still poaching around. Stormtroopers don't move into the church. They just set a move up and take tons of fire. They got weak armor there early on. Going to have to back off and get around Jesus' house. Meanwhile, Brits are taking that plus 10 fuel outside of Recon's base. But let's go back to the middle. Here comes the Ashwin going to make a push. Reveal itself. Oh boy, the Brits are really running now. They won't have anything to do with an Ashwin. Recon going to make a statement here. Hopefully chases those Brits in. I don't think... Oh my goodness. Huge blunder here. Huge blunder. He could walk right in there, finish his game off. Yes, one of the infantry sections God, has a Bren, and he could freeze up that Ashwin. But there's nothing there that can destroy the Ashwin other than the Steward, but the Steward's just getting repaired right now. Oh my goodness, he could have sent that Ashwin in and at least put another herd on. A little bit of payback. There's Nitro again, plaguing the Shoutcast. Here comes the Ashwin, though, going to be wrapping up some infantry sections just north. Of Recon's base. I'm getting distracted by Recon's crap. Or Nitro's stuff. Here comes a Cromwell out from Tox. Going to be moving out, going to be doing its thing. Cromwells have a great accuracy rate against infantry. They are pretty sweet. Got light armor, but they're not that bad. They're quick. They got a little speed boost. Coming out in the middle. Tox really pissed he lost the middle. He's going to be gaining it back. Infantry sections moving up from the south. Recon really falling back now. Going to sit back, put his arms up, and probably try to regroup here. Oh, man, that's good. Good. Two snipers have yet to be healed there. Pioneers getting chased off down south by the captain. 296 to 407. Favor of the British guys. British capping the middle of the map and the southern part. Wehrmacht or Recon in a lot of trouble here. He's sending his snipers out. Going to try and get that captain down south. One shot. Two shots. Captain down. Plus 18 XP coming up. Very nice move for Recon to spot that and bring out two snipers. Assassination. Old school. Another observation post build on that 18 fuel. Here we go. Up top we have the Stuart and the Cromwell right up top. And we have another Cromwell coming out. Another base rape could be possible here. Only one Shrek, really, and an Ashwin to hold off those tanks, but the Ashwin's really not going to be any good against the Cromwells. Here come the snipers moving into the middle with the cloaked stormtroopers, double Shreked, no veterancy. Cromwells and Stuarts moving up north. Going to sweep around the lake and move down south towards the Wehrmacht base. Recon's in for a lot of hurt there. If you're going to the tactical map, you can really see it unveil itself. Recon has spotted those tanks, and he really, I don't know, it should be interesting to see what he does doing in the middle. There's some fighting in the middle. He sends his Shrek squads, stormtroopers, back to the base to regroup and hopefully fend off those tanks. Snipers stay in the middle along with the Geschützwagen and Volks. Ashwin does a number on the infantry sections. P4 and double Shrek squad both at base, going to be able to catch Tox's little base rape here. Double Shrek shot on the Stuart. P4 going to pretty much, should be able to wrap up this. No, P4 taking damage from the Cromwells. Oh my goodness, put those Shreks in the building. Christ, oh goodness. Shreks gain that accuracy bonus while in the buildings. They're very nice to have there in the buildings if you can put them in there. Another Stormtrooper squad coming out into the base. Ashwin coming back to give some help to destroy that Stuart. Stuart's in trouble now. Ashwin's going to put up a couple shots. Stuart probably goes down. There it goes. Two Cromwells still attacking that P4. Shrek squad still down to one man. Another Cromwell down. Decent fight here. Very nice. Tox is really putting the pressure on Recon. Trek's still missing right outside the Recon's base there. Right outside the headquarters, desperately trying to get a Shrek shot off. There it goes. Main gun destroyed. Cromwell going down. There it goes, out of control, and he's out. Meanwhile, in the middle, snipers are poaching those sappers. The only thing Recon really lost in that exchange was a P4. He could probably build another one here in a couple minutes. Excuse me. Now we have a Staghound armored car coming out. Tox really starting to show us how the Brits start to level out towards late game. They really don't have much of a force once they hit the Cromwell stage. All they can really do is sit back on their hands and hope that you don't really pretty much pummel them into the ground. So they'd be really aggressive early on. Infantry section's moving down south, going to be moving up, doing a hook formation. Meanwhile, in the middle, the Austrian attacking the Staghound with the Shrek squads. I think they're both double Shrek. Maybe one is just double Shrek. But one of those guys' squads are pinned. I do know stormtroopers do get pinned much more easily than the other Wehrmacht infantry. They're very delicate guys. They do not like to be fired at. They only like to fire at the Commonwealth people. No action in the Panzer Command Center there out of Recon's base, so no tanks coming out yet. Meanwhile, to the west of the church, and in the church, we have Shreks firing at the Staghound. Zapper's coming in to repair, hopefully going to get it off. Double Shreks going to maybe get a shot off, but they're taking too much damage. There goes the first Stormtrooper squad. Another Stormtrooper squad tries to round the corner of the church, but takes a deadly shell to the face, and one man loses one man. Meanwhile, down south, the infantry sections were pushed off. No bunkers. Just Blitz, Ostwinds, Cromwells, and Stuarts going at each other. Here come the Volks moving in with their MP40s, going to be cleaning up the section in the middle. Another sniper built, going to replace that last one he lost for Recon. Here come the sections moving out of Dog 1, going to be giving some help to the middle. Recon got to get some of this map back, almost halfway through this map, or this replay. Should be a long video for you guys. Longer cast for me. I might have to take a piss soon. Volk squad down in the center. We'll do a time sink. Just bear with me. Infantry section's moving in. They're throwing those grenades at the Auschwitz. Not going to really do much. The Bren going to be opening up on the sniper. Sniper gets away. The Bren could probably blind the Auschwitz. But the Auschwitz going to be Roman free here, just going to be firing at the Staghound. Well, the Staghound really not taking any damage from that Ostwind. None whatsoever. I would have thought it would have taken some damage. He's taking a little bit of damage, but not that much. Huh. I bet your Recon thought the same thing. He was going to be able to destroy that. Meanwhile, Sherman Firefly coming out. Very strange. The Sherman Firefly and then the Sherman tank. I wonder who came up with Sherman first. The Americans? I know my history. I should know it. Meanwhile, we have the tank battling the Firefly. The glass cannon going to be in trouble meeting those two Shrek squads.
Our forward supply lines are broken. Veterans
engage. Two Shreks in trouble there. Going to be firing off at the tank. Sapper's there to repair the center VP. Germans screaming down there. I can hear them way up here in the peanut gallery. Staghound opening up on those Shreks. The Shreks going to give some fires. One shot hits it right in the ass. Sniper moving up to give support to those Shrek squads. Glass cannon sitting back. Another Staghound out. Tox probably going to upgrade it with the other 50 cal to help suppression. Sniper still poaching in the middle. Section moving up from the south. Brit's setting up a nice line of fire here, but he's got no emplacements. No emplacements from Tox right now. An MG emplacement would have been huge right now. Also been chasing off a section down south. Up north, though, it's pretty much commanded by the Brits. Sappers healing up the wounds of the Stackhounds. And the sections in the middle, though, to the western part, we have an infantry section. They're trying to fight off these Shrek squads. Not really going to do much with a sniper back there. Recon's other sniper's still sitting in the base. Wow, that's heating up here. Here come the Stackhounds. They're just north of the center VP, going to be moving in here. Triple vetted Shrek squad's going to be able to hold up to that. They're still getting suppressed, though. The stormtroopers get suppressed easily, even with the vet. Plus, that 50 cal work is not a friendly gun to crowds. Stackhounds chase off the Shreks, which is that's a statement right there. When you have two Stackhound light vehicles chase off two double Shrek Vet 3 stormtrooper squads, you're making a statement there, which means you really can't handle those right now. And that's Tox knows this and is taking advantage of it. If you just look outside of Recon's base, just out by the bunker, oh, you missed. Damn it, I couldn't explain it fast enough. Anyways, let's go back to the Stuarts. Stuart's going to do a little drive-by assassination there, taking out part of that bunker. If that bunker goes down, those infantry sections could hook up top and then move into the Wehrmacht base. And a lot of people think that armor spells the end of a game with a base rape. An armored base rape will not do it. Neither will an all-infantry base rape finish the game off. You have to have both. You have to have a combination of both to finish a game off, especially in these 1v1s or 2v2s. You can't have just paratroopers and riflemen storming a base. It's not going to do it. You need to have both armor and infantry in there to make the base rape early on and finish off the game. If you don't have that, it's best not to do the base rape and just do a drive-by, what we saw Tox just do right there. Section's moving into the middle, though. Here come the stormtroopers, going to give chase to the Stackhounds round two. Stackhounds pretty much owning him up with that 50 cal. Be nice to see a Tiger here out of Recon. He's very close. He's got another 50 manpower to that giant Tiger tank. We'll be seeing that shortly. He does have 800 now. He can probably bring it out. Baswin desperately needs some help. Here comes some pioneers to fix her up. Both forces really committing a lot to the middle. There's the Tiger going to be reaching the action here in a few seconds. The Firefly there going to help out with the Ostwin. Ostwin needs to get repaired fast. One shot from that Firefly could be over. There goes the Ostwin. 12 plus XP, XP flying through the air. Brits pretty much commanding the middle, holding the church. Two VPs controlled by Tox, or controlled by Recon. Let's do a time sync. 26 minutes and 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, about halfway through this replay. After this, I'm going to be watching the NBA Finals. That's basketball or African handball. It's a very cool game. Tall men leaping into the air and slamming a giant round orange thing into a hoop, which is also orange. Could also go for some good tobacco right now, but I can't afford it. Stackhound sitting back there looking across the graveyard at the giant Tiger. Not really going to touch him, are they? Here goes a Stackhound, a brave one. They're going to see that Tiger. They're going to back off real quick. Whoa! Wow, that thing damn near tipped over but didn't take that much damage. Goodness. All in front of Jesus' house. Jesus probably cursing from that tower. Shrek's moving in with the Tiger. Support. Tiger's very strong against everything. Recon as surprised as I am at how effective those Stackhounds are. Grenadier's Vet 3 should be able to hold up with that elite armor against the Stackhounds, but these stormtroopers really aren't much for it. But they're going right after that glass cannon. There they go, going to be chasing that Sherman Firefly away while the tank moves in from the south. Another Firefly just west of the church dueling with the Tiger. Here come the Shreks, going to give support. Commandos diving in. We have seen Commandos now. Snipers there to help out. Meanwhile, the Tiger's going to destroy that glass cannon just off the road. Commandos still fighting those Stormtroopers. Bundle grenade thrower in the Stormtroopers at the center VP. Snipers picking away the Stormtroopers. Stormtroopers got to leave. Meanwhile, the Tiger seems to be immobilized there, just the west part of the church. Lots to see here, folks. We are getting a finale. Here comes the tank, going to be chasing some Brits now. They seem to be on the run there. Badly injured, Stackhound and the Glass Cannon are hurting big time. Going to be moving up north, trying to hide away from the Tiger. Tiger is not immobilized, I apologize. But with the Bren there, the Bren infantry section there, they could be a formidable opponent for the Tiger. Tiger's got to probably get repaired. About 30 minutes through here. Sniper's now moving up with the Shrek squad. Nice thing about the Tiger is you can always call in another one. Ooh, almost an assassination on that lieutenant. Lieutenant's now running. Snipers might get a couple more shots on him. Oh my goodness, both missing. Very lucky. I bet she's wishing he would have vetted up those snipers right now. Snipers continue to move up north, determined to push off the sections and the British up north. Recon really not having that many units this game. He's lost a Volks squad, a Geschützwagen, an Ostwind, a P4.
They're losing territory.
Commandos capping the center VP. What can we do here? It seems that both players have reached the pinnacle of their ladders. Pretty much reached the roof. Both on the roof, dueling it out in the hot sun. But unfortunately, the British roof is shorter than the Wehrmacht roof. Meaning they're not as strong this late game. And damn, down in the center VP, that Tiger collecting the dog tags in the middle. Sniper's still picking off the northern guys in the sections. Right in the northern VP. Capped by that Shrek squad. Tiger giving support to both regions of the map. Sniper's moving in, though. Very gutsy. Wow. Damn, that's got to be a manpower gain. Or drain. Excuse me. Boy, I've been drinking too much. Anyways. Vet 3 Blitz down south. Stormtrooper's going to be capping that as well. We're 226 to 208. Recon taking the lead, finally. Almost over a half of this replay. The trophy sitting right next to me, stinking up this room. Bunker going up just to the eastern side of the center VP. Samoy's a very nice map. Let's do a time sync while we're waiting. 31 minutes and 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45. Best shoutcaster right here in your ear. Creating art just with my voice. Shrek's down south, going to be chasing off some snipers. Tiger holding up in the middle, going to be making its cave. I wouldn't be surprised to see that bunker become a repair bunker. Infantry sections and the Brits still hanging out up north. All VPs capped by Recon. No emplacements built by Tox at the moment. Would have been nice to see at least an MG bunker or something. Maybe, I bet you it would be nice to see a... one of those 17-pounders there just looking down the road. They're right at the crossroads just to the north of the church. That would be a nice place for a 17-pounder. But with the Shreks roaming around as well as the Tiger, it would be very hard to defend, but it'd be worth it. Late game MG coming out from Recon. Very nice to see. I love this. A late game MG, which is rare these days, would work awesome for those 3v3s and 4v4s that we play a lot, guys. I'm telling you, if you build some late game MGs, it'll throw your opponent for a huge loop. And you vet those MGs, they're only 250, and late game, you've probably got enough manpower to freaking float a boat out there. So those late game MGs, the MGs do gain that heal bonus with the vet 1 and vet 2. I believe they do get some sort of armor or health bonus. I know people are going to be screaming about this. But they do get something, and at vet 3, I might get confused, but at vet 3, they might have as much accuracy as the American. They might be more, I think it's vet 2 they gain the accuracy, so they kill the troops faster. And then at vet 3 they gain some range. I might be wrong on that, but we will probably hear it on the forums, as Relax and as the other guys really love to quote me on those stats, keeping me straight on the long road of alcoholism. Pyle's trying to lay down a mine there just to the northwest of the center VP. They got to get out. Commando's going to be moving in here. Tox's going to be moving in full force to the center VP. Recon bracing himself with vet 2 tanks. Here come the Commando's going to roam around the corner of the church and get a wide open view of the Tiger as well as the P4. MG in the bunker there still to give support if it wants. Commando's going to go down if they don't get out. Tiger's going to have a shot on him, though. Nope. Whoa. Commandos, get out of there. Stackhound's going to sit back along with the glass cannon. Another Firefly going to be coming out. Recon really stretching the map here. He's coming out to the southern part of the church. Keep with me, people. We're in the center of the map. Snipers, P4, Tiger facing off against 2 Fireflies and 2 Stackhounds. Infantry section's pretty much obsolete if they don't bring a Bren. Shrek's moving into the middle, joining the fun. Meanwhile, Sappers up top going to be sipping on their tea while they walk, spilling it all over their trousers, and hopefully capping some parts of the map up there. But let's go back to the center. Decent battle here. Shrek's chased off in the middle, just south of the church. Stackhound's there to offer support. It's going to be harder for Tox to battle this because he's got to be able to do a trick dance with the tanks. He's got to be able to bring up the Stackhounds to chase off the infantry Shreks, and then bring up the armored tanks, the Fireflies, to chase off the tanks then. So he's got to do almost like a two-point attack here. Here comes some Arty, it seems to be, right there in the middle of the map. There it is, a few shells coming down, wiping out those poor bunker engineers, or Pios. Love the P4 look, especially with the man sitting up top, and especially with its Vet 3 when it has that armored skirt look. Meanwhile, the Firefly's pretty much given a few shots off on that Tiger. Very strange. I wonder how they have... Oh, they do have those little guys with their heads peeping out. Chasing off the tanks, that's how they had that line of sight. Meanwhile, the Shrek's battling the Stackhounds just north of the center VP. Going to give a couple shots at the Stackhounds. Stackhound's going to think better of it, going to run off. Sniper's going to be back in the action. We do have some sappers up top. They are deploying those detector radio triangulations. Going to be laying those all over the map, I suppose. Cheeky bastards, those British guys. P4 guarding the middle against the Commandos. Commandos just jump in to get a look at the bunker to get an Arty on there. Here comes some Arty there on the bunker. Going to be damaging that bunker. Let's see how far that Arty takes it down. Not enough. Hopefully he can get some repairs on that. MG takes a loss, though. Shrek still pursuing cloaked those Stackhounds. They might get one here with a little clean sweep or pick on it. Tox must have seen it with his little triangulation. That's why he's moving away. But Recon's going to take some shots at the glass cannon. He's going to be going after it. Here comes a section trying to get some shots off at those Shreks. So the Shreks might get a few more off of that Firefly. Firefly out of control. There's another Firefly down. Three of them lost. Here come the tanks now. Going to be jumping on Tox. Recon realizing how bad Tox is really in the dumps here. Going to be moving in here. He's only got one Firefly to battle against with a couple stack hounds. He's got enough Shreks there to last him till the end of ages. Here come the Shreks and be battling out the Commandos. Commandos got to go. Here comes Artie on the tank. The Tiger. P4 giving a few shots on that Firefly, but that P4 shot did nothing to that Firefly. Firefly not as glassy as I thought it would be. Here comes the Tiger going to be its big brother and probably lay down some fire for the P4. Firefly really not going to be able to hold up against the P4 and the Tiger. Stackhound's sitting around watching. Really can't do much here. Hopefully this replay ends soon. This is unbelievable. Here come the tanks moving up north. Great game so far. 189 to 123. Recon clinging onto the lead of the VPs. Tiger moving up on that Sherman Firefly really wants it bad. Section's desperately moving out of the British base. Hoping to get some support, but that Tiger's going to own the day. Main gun destroyed. Tox might get that tank into his base and away. Wehrmacht tank's going to give some chase. Oh, my goodness. Firefly decides to turn around, stop in the bean field, and back up and take some fire. I would have recommended that if that was a real Sherman, American-made, because we know how to make front armor. But the Brits in this game didn't seem to know that. So he turned it against the Tiger, and no matter what, you're better off just trying to run away and not trying to turn it to the front armor, because the Tiger's just going to pierce it anyways. Tiger's got the best gun in the game. Pretty much rivals the King Tiger. Here come the tanks now, going to do a little parade, possibly into the British base. I think Recon lost a Stormtrooper squad. Meanwhile, down south, the Commandos wrecking havoc. Little raiding party. I think he did lose a Shrek squad. Two snipers, Pioneers, P4, Tiger, and a Stormtrooper squad, which just got destroyed at the northern VP with a booby trap, if you will. I think it was a detonation. Wow, two Shreks laying there. Could pretty much turn the tide of this battle if he can get those Commandos up to take those Shreks. That would be unbelievable. But here come the Sappers, maybe going to pick up the loot. Stackhound moving into the base again. Another base rape on Recon. Poor Recon pretty much trying to weather the storm. Recon building another Stormtrooper squad with double Shreks. Sapper's going to look at the loot up north, though, and that's going to pretty much bite on it. He could send some other units to pick up those Shreks. That could be game-changing. Shreks are awesome against Wehrmacht armor. The P4 would certainly go down, I'll tell you that. Stackhound pretty much offering a decent distraction from the rest of the game. Sniper taking pot shots at the Stackhound. Sniper is really in trouble. There you go. Vet 2. 168 to 111. Favor of Recon still. Recon kicking and screaming as he heads back to level it out. As the score levels out. Time scene coming on though. Let's do that while we're at it. Probably the last one of the tournament. Wait for it, folks. This should be a good one. My last drink with you guys. 41-40. 41, 42, 43, 44, 45. Tiger still sitting in the middle, probably calling for some repairs, but no piles there to give any sort of licking to the wounds. Tiger doesn't really give a crap. Here comes some Artie. Commando Artie, but they did pick up the Shreks. The Commandos picked up the Shreks, but they're not going to be any good with the snipers there. Germans have moved on one of our... Here comes the Artie now, throwing up grounds of the road. Infantry section caps the middle. While they cap the middle, they do button the Tiger tank. That was the word I was looking for. Tiger in the middle facing off with the Brens. That's got to be a brave bunch of gentlemen sipping their tea. The Tiger tank pretty much going to come out of its lull from the Brens and blow away those Brits if they can. There it is. Oh, my goodness. Bunch of body parts flying around the center VP. Meanwhile, up the northern VP, the P4 going to be chasing off the Stackhound. Stackhound, not much of a fight against the P4, but the P4 is isolated up there while Sherman Firefly decides to sneak up there and give a little pound into him. But this Firefly is not going to go up there. I would have thought he would have gone up there and isolated the P4, but he's going to go to the middle of the map and guard the middle. Firefly thinking otherwise, now he's going to go back up to the north, realizing what a blunder that move is. It's like moving your bishop out into the middle of nowhere and losing the rook at the same time in a game of chess, if you play chess. Sherman Firefly stopping, giving a few shots on the Panzer IV. The Panzer IV pretty much taking a beating this game. Its armor and paint job pretty much ruined. Knight's Crossoff from Recon. He's not messing around. He's got two VPs now, 127 to 109. Tox losing time as I speak. Two sappers there to repair for Tox. We've got two commandos, and the infantry sections have pretty much gone home to mommy because they've run out of teabags.
An ammo storage facility is being overrun.
Commandos now moving into the northern part of the map. Moving down towards the center of the VP, Stackhounds with two Shreked up commandos. Knights Cross up top doing the capping. Here come the tanks from the Wehrmacht going to be moving in. They've got to avoid those Shreks. Snipers there to offer support against the commandos, though. Allies down to 100 points. Tox has got to make a move soon. Almost down to the very end of the replay in the final game of the finals of the final tournament. Grenade going in on the commandos. Commandos going to take a beating there. They get out. Wow, they're still taking a beating, and they are down. One squad down. Jesus' house is getting cremated. And Knights Cross up north decide to get pushed off by the Stackhounds. Tox going to have to throw in the towel here shortly unless he makes a decent move. He's lost too much. He tried the base rapes early on. 17 powder would still be nice to have. Snipers really doing their tolls. If we check out on the sniper kills, one of them has 30 kills, the other has 36. That's 66, I can add, kills per sniper. That's a lot of manpower, and I don't know how much a British soldier costs in manpower. And if you think of how much, just let alone an infantry section guy, what is it, 45 manpower somewhere around that area? Here comes the train, but that's a lot of manpower right there due to the snipers. And those are the two late-game snipers that he built late-game. Recon floating a ton of manpower. He's about a 1,400 with 150 fuel, just about over that. Commandos down south going to try and do a sneaky thing and grab that southern VP. Very interesting sandbox battle. I wonder if you battled out Vanilla Knight's Cross versus Vanilla Commandos. Knight's Cross might win that, but they're outnumbered. Anyways, Vet 3 on the tanks. Tiger at Vet 3 might be very hard to destroy. He's in the middle. P4 with the Knight's Cross moving down south to give chase to those commandos. Commandos running off. They've got two Shreks. They're going to be outnumbered against those MP44s that the Knight's Cross carry. Tiger's still in the middle chasing off, holding the whole British Army off by itself. Sherman Firefly's opening up on the Tiger. Recon down to pop cap here. He's got a damaged engine. That Tiger's hurting. 127 to 70. VP, I could see a turn in the game. Suddenly, Recon's looking very weak here. Here come the Fireflies with the Stackhounds. Oh my goodness, that P4 could go down. The Tiger's in a lot of trouble. Shreks coming in. It might be too late for the Shreks. Tiger could go down, but Recon could quickly call in another one. That Tiger in the middle could go down. There it goes. Here comes the Arty. P4 is dangerously close to blowing up. Shrek's taking their shots on the Sherman Firefly. Here comes the Arty. Oh my goodness, and wiping out some Knight's Cross. Shrek's deciding to give chase. Here comes some commandos flying in. Oh my goodness, this is just a dollop. Here we go. Shrek's battling the commandos. Stormtroopers don't know what to do. We do have that Blitzkrieg placed on the troops so they can move twice as fast, but they don't have enough. Knight's Cross going to desperately cap the middle. I don't think Recon's realized he can bring in the Tiger Tank. Can he? It's 14. He does. Here comes the new Tiger. He's got to call it in. That P4 goes down. Going to free up some pop cap for Recon. Recon's got to make a move. 114 to 69. VP still in favor of Recon. Recon kicking and screaming as Tox seems to be picking him up and throwing him out of the Windtime house. Meanwhile, Recon's not giving up, and he is throwing some lobs of Shreks at that other Sherman Firefly. There's another one down. Tons of tank wreckage is just laying around out here. Firefly and StatCount still in the middle. Even on the VPs, one cap by each player. Here comes some snipers with a new Tiger Vet 3. That is going to be a bad boy. Recon got to get to the middle while Tox is capping. He's got to make a move. He's deciding to show his ass armor of the Tiger to that lovely Sherman Firefly. Sherman Firefly still doing its job. Throwing some red smoke on the Tiger. Whoa! My good... That Tiger throwing in a shell at those repairing sappers. Those sappers took a beating. Meanwhile, the commando Shreks jump into the building, but they're running out of the cafe. I think they're triple Shrek. Watch this! Oh my goodness, triple Shreks. I have not seen this before. Oh goodness. Lots of damage dealt to that Tiger. With the triple Shreks. Unbelievable. Very cool. They're still firing. The commando's holding out there. Whoa! Lots of Shrek fire coming in. Here comes some more red smoke. Unbelievable. Grenade bundle thrown in on the commandos. Taking out a few commandos. Commandos attack. Gotta go. Get them out of there. Oh my goodness. All the vet. God. The double Shrek. The triple Shrek commando squad taken out by the Knight's Cross. Oh, that was it. That could have been the game. That could have been it right there. If he would have had those triple Shrek squad, he might have been able to take out that Tiger. But now the Tiger is pretty much buffed up by that. He's going to be moving into the middle. Here comes red smoke on the center VP. Here comes the already wiping out clean that Knight's Cross. Their bodies go flying. Tiger moving into the western side. Going to be dealing some damage to the Sherman Firefly. Snipers moving in with the Pios. Somebody's got to cap the center VP. A sniper volunteers. Tiger's still chasing the Sherman Firefly. Tiger thinks best of it. He's only got a sliver of health left. Oh, man. A Sherman Firefly fires its last shot coming out of nowhere, taking out the Tiger tank. Another Tiger called out by Recon. Going to take a few seconds for him to get towards the center of the map. Shreks, meanwhile, destroying the main gun off the wounded Sherman Firefly. Sapper's gone down. Tox has nothing to cap anything. We have a great finals game here. 95 to 66 in the VP count. Oh my goodness. We still have the Stormtroopers chasing out the Sherman Firefly. Meanwhile, Commandos in the middle are going to be doing some damage to the Pio. Is going to be able to cap the middle here. Snipers trying to make their way back. They got mud in their boots with the cement heels, trying to make their way back to the center of the map and disrupt the commandos from capping. Tigers moving in, scaring off the commandos. Commandos use smoke to kind of hide away from the Tiger. Gonna sweep around the Tiger. Very nice move. Tiger's still there though. Spots him. Here come the snipers. Gonna do some poaching, taking out two commandos. Meanwhile, the enemy or allies Tox does go down to 50 points. He's at 45, 95 to 45, about 52 minutes. Great game so far. Stick with me, folks. Tiger pretty much owning the day up in the middle. Panther now coming out for Recon. That's a Vet 3. Strongest armor in the game on the front of that tank. You might be saying, hey, Doug, you know, the Tiger has stronger armor. Well, Panther armor is on the front of the Tiger as well. Great game, well played. We loved watching this. It was worth the wait, folks, and worth the cast. I'm going to be putting that dirty sock into the mail soon, and thank God I don't have to pay the price to mail it to Australia. But well played. Tox pretty much owning the northern part of the bracket. And Recon, or Tox owning the southern part, Recon owning the northern part of the bracket. Great game. Tox might have tripped over himself playing Brits. The replay ends, and there's the tournament, the last tournament. Thanks, guys. Thank you, guys, for keeping up with the tournament. We want to thank all the guys who played the game, who played the tournament, participated. We want to thank all you guys who watched these things. I wanted to thank AvderoOoS, most of all. He was the guy who put this together. Thank Defoth and the other admins for letting us put this on. We hope you enjoyed this. I'm sure there's another one right around the corner. AvderoOoS should be doing some casts. But there's only one place to find an Uncle Woo cast, and that's right here where you're listening to right now. I'm sure I'll be releasing a few here and there. Send me them if you think they're worthy of it. I don't mind doing a cast here and there. I'm pretty much going to be busy. But, guys, love that you guys watched it. Feedback, always appreciated. And, as always, Easy Company, game on.